is making me crazy. All right, we're back on this Booze Day Tuesday with more of Today and a new movie about to hit the big and small screens all at once.
Yeah, the movie's about a young woman who's hit by a car and in need of a little surgery. The problem is she's alone and has no one to take care of her.
So who would you turn to? Your family, your friends, or perhaps an ex-boyfriend?
What?
That's what Leslie Bibb's character Franny did in the new film Take Care. Look.
You know Franny.
Yeah.
He agreed to be my primary caregiver.
What?
What? You're taking care of her? For how long?
Hard to say.
Got a ballpark?
Everyone's different.
Right,
and I'll tell you, here's what I'm comfortable saying to you. Anywhere between 6 weeks and 27 years, does that work for you?
It's such a cute movie.
I love it.
Yes, we love it. Leslie Bibb plays Franny. She's here along with Liz Tuchino, who directed the film. And it's fun to watch the two of you away from you guys.
Girlfriends, too.
I love them. Remind us of us.
Doing an indie film together, either it's going to make the best of friends or the worst of enemies.
You're going to go out punching and pulling out
hair. This is your directorial debut.
Yes, it is.
But you're obviously affiliated with two very big movies that we know a lot about, Sex and the City.
And he's just,
and he's just not that into you.
Yeah, that little show, Sex and the City.
What was it like driving? Yeah. What was it like driving this bus?
It was terrifying. Everyone talks about the first filmmaking experience as being horrifying because everybody's looking at you and expecting you to know what you're doing, and you don't.
Yeah.
And you look around and everybody
but
knows what they're
so
doing
prepared.
More. Oh, yeah. Okay.
No, you were, and we would show up at her apartment, and we would do rehearsals, and it was a real labor of love.
Yeah. It helps to surround yourself with a ton of friends, right?
Yes.
Know what they're doing.
Yeah, and also just, everybody there was much more experienced than me, which was fantastic.
But
for
you know
me.
What people love to do? They like to be asked, help me. Tell me, what should I be? Am I doing this right? Mm-hmm. People respect that.
Now, but it was like a lot of like NYU students too, because we had no money when we made this
right,
movie.
Right.
And you have like all these kids who would just show up, and they were amazing.
Yeah.
And they did an amazing job.
Now, the concept's interesting, Leslie. Your ex-boyfriend is going to help you through a very difficult time.
Your friends desert you.
Why? And my sister wants to move out to New Jersey.
You were smart not to go with her.
Why does he owe you?
He owes me because I nursed him through cancer, and when he got better, he dumped me.
Mm.
And
that's terrible.
That's terrible. And so right when this accident happens,
he
has just sold his company for $6 million to Yahoo. So he has all this money, and it's not about the money. It's just like, you jumped me, and I helped you.
Yeah.
Through
and
this.
My timing was terrible.
And my timing.
And he's got a new girlfriend, which complicates things.
Yes, and perhaps I think a little bit of a unfinished business between the two of them.
Always.
Yes.
That's the predictable part.
Yes.
You want the two of you to get together.
Yes. Okay. I mean, that's the thing, because it's kind of, we were scared. We're like, you're kind of dealing with sort of murky territory because he does have a girlfriend, and that. You want
life is murky, young one.
After her. She'll get you. Be careful.
When Barbara Corcoran's here, I'm sorry, I'm a different animal.
Barbara's on steroids.
Life is murky,
young one.
I like the young one. I'll take it.
Okay, so you're very happily dating someone, aren't you?
Yes. Who? The wonderful Sam Rockwell.
Oh,
he's
adorable. How is that?
So happy she's got dreamy eyes.
Dreamy eyes. Look at the two of you.
And how long have you been together?
7 years.
Still dreamy eyes.
I am super cuckoo for him. I'm cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs for him. He's delicious.
Sweet. All right, we're going to play a little game. All right, we're going to get tips on dating, do's and don'ts. Okay?
Oh, brother.
Liz, you wrote the book about all this kind of
stuff. She calls herself a relationship know-it-all, not an expert.
No, because that implies that I know something. But know-it-all just means I think I know something.
Yes, that's true. It's true.
All right, online dating, is it worth its time or a waste?
Worth its time. And I'm just the boss.
Welcome to set. Here we go.
It's worth its time.
What do you think?
I would say it's worth its time, but for some people, I've had a terrible experience, but it's sort of a numbers game, so the more people you meet, the more chances are you're going to meet somebody.
Okay.
Kim Bibb married her husband, my sister, married her husband. Kim Bibb, I always call her Kim Bibb. Kim Bibb met her husband on Match.com.
Lots of stories like that.
Okay, now before you date, Liz, do you think you should stalk the person online, or should you just have a blind date?
Well,
and just meet them.
Of course, the answer is you shouldn't. You should just go in fresh. But of course, you do. Because, I mean, it's right there. There's a keyboard. Are you crazy?
I like her honesty.
You have to do a little Google search.
Oh, listen, we can stay with you guys
forever. Do we have any extra time?
He's saying goodbye. Goodbye.
Oh, I mean,
Zach's saying goodbye.
No.
We don't want you to leave.
It's like my rejection issues are happening.
Blame Zach.
All right, listen,
ladies,
it's an adorable movie. Wish
you
all the best.
Movie.
Where can people see it?
Take Care. Don't forget the name. It opens in theaters and on demand on December 5th. It's perfect to do during the holidays. Cozy up.
Yes.
That's adorable.
All right.